हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज राजेश दादीच फ्रॉम शिवज्योति एजुकेशन ग्रुप कोटा. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक योर क्लास फॉर इंग्लिश ग्रामर, राइट? सो वन ऑफ द चैप्टर्स इज प्रेजेंट टेंस, अनदर चैप्टर इज पास्ट टेंस, एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज फ्यूचर टेंस. सो ओवरऑल वी कैन से वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज योर चैप्टर 5, 6, 7, द टेंसेस. ओके, रेस्पेक्टिवली द प्रेजेंट टेंस, द पास्ट टेंस एंड द फ्यूचर टेंस. Before we proceed, first of all, we have got to know what the term tenses is, right? Tenses means all actions. You just count on all actions you perform from birth till last breath, right? So the sum up of the product of all the activities one performs throughout one's lifetime is known as the tenses or the lifespan, right? We can divide our whole lifespan into three parts: our present, our past, our future, right? So exactly in the same way we can say we have divided the term tenses in three equal parts, just like the parts of life. Got it? The past means what we already lived. This is the actual sequence, right? But in tenses, the actual sequence is the present tense, the past tense and the future tense. But in life cycle, past first, because whatever we have lived, that has elapsed, that becomes past. And whatever we are living in, that is a present. And whatever we plan to live in is a future, right? So it makes no difference what the sequence is. But the thing is, the tenses also divide into three parts: the present tense, the past tense and the future tense. Got it? Next, let's classify these three tenses into their four subtypes, right? First one is simple or indefinite. You may call simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense, or present indefinite, past indefinite, or future indefinite. Getting? Next is continuous tense, or you may call it progressive as well, right? The next one is perfect. Next is perfect continuous. So these are some common subtypes, right? These are same in found past tense, these are same in found future tense. So they are found equally in all these three tenses. So overall we can say 12 subtypes are there, but generally we say 12 tenses are there. For facilitation only, we have divided this life cycle, this time period, into four fragments, right? So to begin with, the present tense. What is present? Present means current time. Yes, whatever time we have got in our hands, whatever we have time to utilize in, that is known as present tense. Got it? So first is present indefinite. Present indefinite means we are talking about the routine activities, daily life activities, universal truths, some factual truths we are talking about. So these are included in this tense. Present indefinite means routine activity. In easy language we can say routine activities are included in this tense. Got it? Got my point? So let's see what are the salient features of present indefinite tense. Generally in affirmative sentences, we use either first form of the verb, or sometimes we add SOS to this first form of the verb. Means sometimes we use V1 and sometimes we use V1 and SOS. But how? What is the criteria? So the basic criteria is whenever the subjects are I, you, we, they, means first person singular, first person plural. In grammar we can say first person singular, first person plural, second person singular, second person plural, and third person plural. Got it? But in easy way you can keep it in your mind, only four words: I, we, you, they. We use V1. And if the subjects are he, she, it, means third person singular, only third person singular, we add SOS to this first form of the verb. I go, we go, you go, they go. Right? But he goes, she goes, it rains. Got my point? So in affirmative sentence. But when we are going to convert this affirmative sentence into negative or interrogative, what we use? Do or does as helping verbs. And obviously when we are using do or does, purely first form of the verb is required. So what we learn? I go, I do not go. Do you go? He goes. She does not go. Does she go? Where does she go? In this way, right? Next is present continuous tense. What is present continuous tense? Means present progressive tense. Means something, some actions we are talking about are in progress, right? Something is going on at the time when we are speaking. Yes, what are you doing? No, sir. I'm doing nothing. It means I was talking about the activity which I found going on, right? I am standing. This is present continuous. You are sitting. This is present continuous. I am teaching. This is present continuous. You are learning. This is present continuous tense, right? So we can say in short that in present continuous tense is or am. What? Is or am. Helping verbs are used. He is, she is, it is, right? You are, we are, they are, and I am, right? And V1-ing. So please keep it in your mind that in all continuous tenses, in all perfect continuous tenses, so how many are there? 6. 3 continuous and 3 perfect continuous tense. So overall, out of 12, 6 tenses are there which take V1-ing form, right? Because continuity is there, right? So what to say? He is going, you are going, I'm going. She is learning, they are learning, I'm learning. Got it? I'm not learning, he's not going. Likewise. Next is present perfect tense. What is present perfect tense? Tell me, what is present perfect tense? Present perfect means present plus perfect. Present means current time, perfect means finished. So whenever we are talking about something that is already complete, so we can say present perfect, right? Have you done your work? So many times you might have come across this sentence in your school classroom. Your teachers, your respective subject teachers might have asked you, yes, students, stand up. Have you done your work? Have you completed your work? Have you collected the copies? Like this, right? Means the teacher is asking about the completion. Okay, so what helping verbs are used? Has or have? It all depends on the subjects given in the sentence, right? I already told you in an easy way you can learn the names of subjects, like he has, she has, it has, he is, she is, it is, he goes, she goes, it rains. Got it? So here, he has, she has, it has, but all plurals means first person singular plural, second person singular plural, and third person plural get have along with third form of the verb. So what I told you, ing form, all 6 tenses, 3 continuous tenses and 3 perfect continuous tenses. Got it? And 3 perfect tenses are there. In all 3 perfect tenses, we use third form of the verb. So 9 tenses we have learned. So I have resolved your problem how to keep the forms of verbs in our mind according to the names of tenses. So got it? All 3 continuous, all 3 perfect continuous, V1-ing, and all 3 perfect tenses, V3. Got it? Next, present perfect continuous. The name itself suggests that this tense is the combination of 2 words. This tense is the combination of 2 words, present perfect and present continuous tense. Means some salient features we have taken out from present perfect and some features we have taken out from present continuous tense. Got it? So overall we can say this is present perfect continuous tense. Let's read what we use as salient features. What I told you, some salient features we have taken out from present perfect, and they are has or have. You can see here also has have, because perfect word is there. That's why has have are common, right? Next is continuous word is there. So continuous word is there. So from this tense we have taken out V1-ing. You can see here V1-ing. So time is also there. Means time of commencement. Something is going on. At present something is going on. Don't get confused. The same thing I taught to you in the present continuous tense also, that something is going on. Something is going on. Then naturally, spontaneously, you might have been confused. So when something is going on in both the tenses, then what makes them different? You are right. In this tense, we know only one thing, something is going on. But in this tense, we know two things, something is going on as common. And one more thing, when something started, we are talking about so-called something. So when that something started, this is also known to us in this tense. For example, I am teaching you, right? Have I told you when I started teaching you? Of course not. Nobody knows when I started teaching you. According to the sentence, I am teaching you. So this is, I am teaching you. But if I say, I started teaching at 8:30. Suppose, if I started teaching you 8:30 and since then, the work is going on. So what to say? I have been teaching you since 8:30 for 2 hours. Now the confusion is where to use since and where to use for. Most of the students get confused. Nothing to worry about. Very simple solution is whenever the countable time has been given to you. Countable means we are talking about a certain period of time. What kind of period? Period means period of days, minutes, hours, weeks, months, and years. I think all these time zone are countable. So we can say for countable time, we can use for 2 days. Days are counted. Days are countable. Yes. So that time days were counted. How many days I took while completing this course. So days, weeks, hours, minutes, seconds, centuries, decades, etc., etc. Right? And since this point of time means uncountable time, fixed time we are talking about. Like since January, since Sunday, since last night, since 2017. Yes, no. I have been teaching here since 2019. Right? But if I say, I have been teaching here for 2 hours, for 2 years, for 2 days, 2 months, but I have been teaching since Sunday, since last year, since 2018, since 2019, like this. Okay, so I have been, right now I have been teaching you since morning at 8:30. Got it? So in this way, this is present tense. Present tense is complete. I know example is better than precept. You need some examples, so just wait. I'll explain all these 4 tenses exactly in the same way through examples, and I hope you would get them in a better way. Just hold on. You can see all these 4 tenses I'm going to explain. So you are suggested to open your book. You have to open your book at page number 32, right? Just open your book at page number 33, right? Exercise A is there. So I'm writing some, randomly I have picked out some sentences, right? So please note them down. Page 33, exercise A. Okay, and the sentence number is 5. Randomly I have picked. Okay, so the sentence is, a stitch in time. Then the sentence remains incomplete. Means some options have been given to you before you start exercise, right? Out of the given options, we have to pick out, or in other words, we can say this exercise is a bunch of, is a collection of idioms and phrases. So likewise, we have to complete a stitch in time. What to write? Saves 9. Okay, this is an idiom. A stitch in time saves 9. Means we should do everything well on time. In this way, we can avoid so many perils and dangers in our life. Got it? So I think all idioms and phrases are expressed through present indefinite. That's why saves is there, right? One more example, don't worry. And this is example number 6. What is this? Barking dogs. Only this. Barking dogs. How to complete? The idiom is barking dogs. Means the clouds, that thunder, never bring rain. Generally, they never bring rainfall. Right? So exactly with the same meaning we have to complete it. Barking dogs. Seldom bite. Yes. Who says the dog is in front of you, and if that dog is not barking at you, it means you have to be aware of that dog, because it may bite you anytime. Because whatever the dogs are barking at you, they generally keep barking only. They do not feel like biting. Just an idiom. So this is also present indefinite tense. Okay. Next, let's switch to next exercise. And please open it, page 35. And on page 35, and this is exercise C. Okay, randomly some more sentences. Sentence 6 of this exercise. And in this, we have been instructed to use present continuous tense. Obviously, present continuous already given. It means is, are, am, along with V1-ing form we have to use. Right? So, we have been told to write some sentences on India's wildlife. So, on my own, I am writing some sentences. In bracket has been given teacher guides. Only this. Teacher guides. Teacher means subject and guides means verb. So we have to, and it has been given in present indefinite. So we are going to convert this present indefinite into present continuous, means using is, are, am, V1-ing. Our teacher is guiding, because guides has been given, that is present indefinite, and in present continuous is, are, am plus V1-ing, so we have done it. Guiding So, got it, students? This is present continuous tense. Let's switch to next exercise. In a better way, we'll be doing, and that is page number 37. Please open it. Page 37 and exercise D. And I have picked out a sentence. Sentence number 4. The passengers, in bracket, wait verb has been given in the form of verb, right? The passengers, what to say? The passengers, and mind it, this, the spelling of this word often confuses the students, the passengers. Generally, students write P-A-S-S-A-N-G-E-R, mind it, passenger E-N-G-E-R, the passengers, then blank space is there. And in bracket, verb is wait for the train. For the past half an hour. So, what I told you, whenever since oblique for plus time has been given to you, since for means perfect continuous, mind it, okay. So, we have to use has been or have been plus V1-ing form. So, V1-ing means waiting and helping verb has been, have been. So, the subject is plural. So, we have to go for have been. I already explained. Have been waiting. Got my point? So in this way, what? You need one more example. Okay, one more example let's do. And that is seventh example of the same exercise. Okay, father blank lived in this city since his childhood. Father blank live out in bracket in this city since his childhood means when father himself was just a child since then. Okay, so since has been given here, for was given, so what to say? Again we are going for perfect continuous tense. Has been, have been, v1 ing, live means living, and helping verb, father is singular. Here the subject was passengers, that's why we went for have been, but now the subject is singular, so we'll go for has been. Has been living. Father, oh, my father has been living here, you're living in this city since his childhood. So in this way, dear students, and in this way your present tense is complete.